Welcome to our introduction to limits in a chapter where we're going to spend a lot of time exploring limits and what is the meaning of limits. So we're going to start here with an introduction to this topic by taking a look at tangent lines to curves and instantaneous velocities of moving objects. So that's where we're going to start. Just give us a foundation to build the need to look at limits. Like, why would we want to look at a limit? So let's talk about it. Why would we want to look at a limit? So to start, let's just go over a couple of quick pieces of vocabulary coming out of probably geometry for you or possibly some other topic, but let's talk about the meaning of a tangent line and a secant line. So what does it mean to talk about a tangent? A tangent means that we're going to touch a curve. So in the context of a curve, we're going to be touching a curve. In the context of a circle, it means that we're just touching the circle at a single point. So on this particular circle right here, obviously this is a tangent line because we're just touching it at a single point, versus a secant line where we actually cut through the circle in 2 points. So we're cutting through the circle in 2 points. When we reference that to a curve, that means that we're going to be passing through the curve in 2 points. So we're going to take these two vocabulary words and we're going to apply them to the context of actual curves and functions. But I just wanted to remind us that they actually come out of geometry. We've thought about them in geometry, looked at them in geometry, and now let's apply them in calculus to some curves. So let's take a look. So if I have a function, and I'm just going to draw, pick your favorite function. Let's draw a curve that looks something like this, and we're going to call it y equals f of x. And then let's go ahead and just pick a point on that function, and let's call that a f of a. The ordered pair for that point would be a f of a. We could call it p. Give it a name for that point if we want to. And if we wanted to draw in the tangent line at that point, it would be the line that represents the curve, touches the curve right at that point. So we're you could take out a ruler. I didn't even grab a straight edge. I just eyeballed it on that one. But you could take out a straight edge and draw in a line that would represent essentially what's happening to the curve right at that point. If we could zoom magnify this to 1,000 times, 10,000 times, 100,000 times, and get way in on that point, then the curve would behave similar to a line. And what would that line look like? It would be the tangent line. So we're just doing this, kind of eyeballing it to get us a sense, and then we're going to clean it up and make it exact with calculus in the next couple sections. But if we get in here and we take a look right there, that's what the tangent line would look like. It would be the line that passes through that point and touches, tangent, and touches the curve. It touches the curve right there at that point. So how would we find the slope, right? So the question comes up, how do we actually find, right? What if the goal here was to find the slope of the tangent line? Well, we could call that, I'm going to give it a name, I'm going to call it m sub tan for the slope of the tangent line. How do we find that? How do we figure out the slope of a tangent line? And so then we have to think, well, how do we find the slope of any line? To find the slope of a line, you need 2 points. And then you can take the difference of the 2 points, right? Let's just remember slope real quick, right? If we wanted to find the slope, we use m, the variable m. It comes from the French word monter, to climb. But to find the slope, we would actually need two points, right? We need y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, right? Little algebra review right there, but we need 2 points. The problem is, with a tangent line, we just described how to find a tangent line, what a tangent line is, and the problem is we only have 1 point, right? That's what makes it a tangent line. It's only hitting the curve at a single point. So what do we do? This is where the idea of a secant line comes in. And what we're actually going to do is we're going to say, okay, the tangent line only has a single point on the curve, but a secant line would have 2 points on a curve. So we're going to use secant lines to estimate tangent lines. So what we're going to do is we're going to come in here, we're going to pick another point. So let's just pick another point on the curve. So pick another point on the curve. right? Why don't we call it Q? We call it Q. This guy was A, F of A, so this will be B, F of B. So let's pick another point over here, maybe right about here, and this is going to be point Q, and we're going to call it B, F of B. Okay, so it's over here at B. I guess we could have labeled A down here too. So this was at A. Okay, so we're going to say, all right, now we have 2 points. So now we can actually find the slope of the secant line. So M of the secant line, I'm going to do this in blue for the secant line. Let's draw the secant line. I haven't even drawn the secant line. So there's the secant line right there. It went off my screen, but there is the secant line. So we can actually draw the secant line right there between the 2 points. And then if we wanted to find the slope, now we have 2 points. A secant crosses the curve in 2 points. So now if we wanted to find the slope of the secant line, right, and that is going to be the slope of the line through P and Q, right, the line through PQ, that's going to be the difference in the y's, F of B minus F of A over B minus A. And that's how we could find the slope of the secant line. But let me ask you this question. Is that secant line the same as the tangent line? And your answer should be no, not at all. It's not at all. It's an estimate. It's not a very good estimate, the one I drew here. It's not a very good estimate. And what we need to do is figure out how can we come up with a better estimate. So we picked B right here. This is where we picked B. How could I actually make this a better estimate of the tangent? Well, I need to move B closer to A. I need to take this B and I need to get it closer to A. I need to move this point closer. Maybe instead of where I picked it, I should have picked it right here, because look at what happens right there when I draw the secant line. That secant line, let's call this secant line 1, and let's call this secant line 2. And secant line 2 is definitely a better estimate. Okay, so in order to get a better estimate of the tangent, and that's what we're going to be doing here today, is finding estimates of our equations of our tangent lines to curves, slopes first, and then we'll all go through the algebra and write the equations of the lines. But in order to get a better estimate, we have to bring our secant line closer to the tangent line. That's how we're going to end up getting an estimate for the slope of the tangent line and be able to write the equation of the tangent line. So we need to be able to do that. We need to bring our values for Q, the second point, not the point that's on the tangent line, but the second point that we use for the secant line, we need to bring that closer to that first point P so that we can come up with an estimate for our secant lines. So that's an overview of what we're going to do for the tangent lines. And I do want to get in and I want to talk a little bit about notation. As we do this, as we drag that point in closer, instead of calling it B, we're actually going to come in here and we're going to call it X. So instead of calling it B right here, we're going to come in and we're going to say, let's call that X, because it's going to be variable. We're going to change it. And this we're going to call, instead of B, F of B, we're going to call X, F of X. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to let X, this is some notation coming actually from our second section, but I'm going to introduce it in this section because it intuitively makes sense to talk about it here. We're going to let that value X get close to A. This notation, this X arrow A, this is saying X approaches the value. Remember, X is the variable, but it approaches the value A. Okay? So that's what we're going to do. We're actually going to let X approach A. And as X approaches A, the slope of our secant line, so remember the slope of our secant line now is going to be the slope through the point through the line PQ, through the 2 points, the slope of the line through the 2 points P and Q. But remember, Q is a variable point now. We're going to let it be X and F of X, and we're going to get it closer and closer to the point P, which is A, F of A. So as we do that, we're going to actually write it this way. So the slope through the line PQ is going to be F of X minus F of A over X minus A. So that's going to be our slope, because remember, and that's going to, the key here is that we're actually letting X get really close to A. And now we're going to introduce one more little piece of notation here, and that is this, that the slope of the tangent line is actually going to be this new notation, LIM, for limit. It's going to be the limit of the slopes of the secant lines as X approaches A. So this is actually going to be the limit as x approaches a of f of x minus f of a over x minus a, because that is what the slope of our secant line looks like. And so this is what we're going to work with. We're going to we'll talk a little bit about the notation in this section, but this is the expression and what we're going to look at. We're going to actually look at those. We're going to get into some nitty gritty here, and we're going to look at the slopes of those secant lines, and we're going to create tables and actually pick some values for x and let those values get closer and closer and closer to a and see what we can come up with there. So as we do that, we're going to see what ends up happening. And I just noticed here I dropped a parenthesis, so I'm going to add it right in. Okay. So that's where we're headed. That's our introduction to limits. And if we take a look here, I typed it up as well. And we can see in order to come up with an estimate, we're going to later call it a limit. As I mentioned, for the slope of a tangent line, we just choose a point a little bit further away, call it Q, and march it in closer to P. Doing that is this process of taking a limit, allowing the variable point Q get closer and closer and closer to P. And so here I also wrote this up in a little bit more formalized form. So if you want to, I'll leave this as our closing screen on this video. If you want to take notes on that, this would be a good time to pause the video, take some notes, write down what's the slope of a secant line between two points, and what's the slope of a tangent line. And the slope of the tangent line is when we let that second point get closer and closer and closer, and we look at this new concept called a limit.